Welcome to our next InnovaPhone My Apps tutorial. In this video, we will be introducing the basic functions of the My Apps phone app and soft phone app. First, please go ahead and open the phone app or soft phone app in your My Apps client. With My Apps, the user interfaces of the phone app and soft phone app are identical. The difference between the two is that the phone app manages a desk phone, while the soft phone app is a fully functional soft phone. The desk phone that we will be using in this video is an IP222, while the softphone app will turn any device such as a smartphone, laptop, tablet or desktop computer into a telephone. If you click on the hamburger button at the top right corner, you will get to the settings. Here you can determine whether the video image shall be transmitted automatically with a call and whether application sharing and video shall always be brought to the front. Here, you can also configure your call diversions, which we will be discussing in a separate tutorial. You can select the video camera that is to be used, the ring device, the ringtone, and the profile. Here, you can also view the installed version of the app. In the search field, you can select a phone number either via the keyboard or via the cursor of your mouse and the virtual numeric keypad. You can also enter a name to search for a contact. Contacts that match the search entry will then be listed. Further, you can also use the search options on your desk phone. Once you click onto the handset symbol next to the contact in the search field or the call history, the call will be initiated. If you use the search field to find a contact, you can start the call by clicking onto the bottom part of the listed information. You can also initiate a call by picking up the handset of your desk phone or by pressing the green handset symbol next to the contact information. You can pause the audio and video transmission of a call anytime by pressing the hold button. The other person will hear recorded music. To continue the conversation and the transmission, simply press the button once again. If you press the mute button, only the microphone will be turned off. You can accept incoming calls either by pressing the green handset button or by clicking onto the system notification if My Apps is not running in the foreground. Of course, you can simply pick up the handset of your desk phone to accept calls or press the green handset symbol on your desk phone. By pressing the red handset symbol, the call will be terminated in the app and at the desk phone. You can also simply hang up the handset. Below the search field, you can view your call history with incoming, outbound, and missed calls. By clicking next to the present status and the profile picture of the contact, details on all calls and call attempts will be listed. You can also start a chat with a contact here, send a callback request, and add the contact to your favorites by clicking onto the star symbol. The selected favorites will be listed at the top above your call history. The favorites and your call history are also displayed on your desk phone in sync with the app. Here you can also send a message or add the contact to your favorites by clicking onto the star symbol. The video transmission will start automatically once a phone call is established. Please note that the person you will be talking to must also support video. You also need to make sure that you have not deactivated the video transmission in your settings. The video transmission can be stopped, restarted, or disabled during a call. You can undock the video screen from My Apps and resize and position it as you please. Once you close the window, the video screen will be docked back onto the client. We will show you the functions on application sharing and how to set up conferences in the following tutorials. Thanks for watching and see you next time.